From the Whitman Guard Armory in Whitman, Massachusetts, it's the NEABF on ABT. Hello everyone, I'm Peter McGowan and welcome. This is the second night of fight action on ABT, all boxing television. I'm along with Paul Stivaletta at ringside here. We're getting ready for the first fight. John Horrigan's here too, folks. And we're ready for a great battle. This is for the championship, Paulie. This is a big night for the guys.
Yes, it's a very exciting night for them. You can see the tension building up here. And, we're looking at a winner in the red corner right now. That was last night's fight. And we're ready to...
Marco Joubert.
Marco Joubert, yes, that's him.
He's fighting Pastagna.
We'll go to Dave Glavin in the ring.
In the home of the 101st NBA, veterans of the best and strong in the Gulf War. This evening's bouts are sanctioned by the Massachusetts State Boxing Commissioner, the Honorable Jocko Arnadian Commissioner. Chair. Also, in the New England media offices, internal officials this evening, James Romeo, President Bill Connolly, Vice President Robert Roach, Treasurer, and Herb Weissel, Executive Director. Internal officials this evening are Charles Steen-Scioli and Clifton. Chief of Officials, Nick Prevent. Your judges for this evening's bout are Ray Belisio from Somerset, Mass. Leo Gessler from Melrose, Mass. And Peter Monica from East Boston. Your referee in charge of the first bout this evening is Paul Redd from Arlington, Mass. Your physician in attendance at ringside this evening is Richard Greenberg from Rockton, Mass. Your official timekeeper at ringside this evening is Tucker Gall, also from Rockton, Mass. At this time, I'd like to ask the official timekeeper to sign 10 bell toll for all those deceased boxes and people involved in the game over the years. Please, everyone, come on.
Here to go on ABT, the first fight. It's going to be a 85-pound battle here, Paulie. It's going to be Marco Joubert versus Edwin Pastagna. We're going to have to find out how the Pastagna folks check that. They're both fighting out of the Haverhill Boxing Club. And there's Marco Joubert. He has the same white trunks as he wore. And fighting out of the blue corner, Pastagna, folks, I'll get it right. He has the yellow trunks trimmed in blue. And we saw Joubert fight last night. He really took the fight to his opponent last night. It was Dave Reed he fought last night, but we're ready to go. And there's the bell, and round one's underway. They touch gloves, and here we go. Looks like Pastagna is kind of has the southpaw look to him, Paulie.
Yes, he does, and he's probably going to be one of those who switch over the other side as he goes along. Sometimes they start out southpaw to confuse their opponents, and we'll see in just a moment what he's going to do.
Left hand landed. Well, it might have grazed the padding on the side of the head of Joubert. Here we go. It's kind of a feeling out process here in the championship match. A quick combination landed there by Pastagna.
That was a nice right hand he got in because he's a southpaw, and when you fight a southpaw, you got to be watching out for that right hand because it's right in your face at all times.
It kind of confuses you a bit, I guess.
Yes, well, you have to change, like I say, your combination is the opposite when you're fighting a southpaw. So mm-hmm. Southpaw, when he's standing up in front of you, his right hand is right in your face. So
Pastagna, he's staying on that southpaw stance, but Joubert's coming right at him. He's got him on the ropes in the corner, and a couple of punches landed to the head of Pastagna, and he gets out of it, but a few punches landed by Joubert.
Yes, they do. They have, and it seems to me that both of these boys are really respecting one another. They're very cautious right now, and I think they're saving their energy and trying to feel each other out for the second and third round. We're going to see some real action here.
Paulie, they're both fighting out of the Haverhill Boxing Club. You think that's got anything to do with the feeling out process?
Well, I guess all boxing clubs, whether it's Haverhill or not, should teach their fighters to be this way. And of course, some fighters come out and they're ready in action, and they all have different tactics. But I think this is a good one. They've been very respectful. But as the rounds go on, I guess they'll have to get more action. To get points, and not only that, but the crowd will start booing if they don't.
There's a big crowd here tonight. Paulie, it's a 20-point must system. The winner gets 20 points. The loser of the round gets 19 or less. And that'll do it for round number one.